anyways, watching the movie, I saw a lot of similarities. I was like, y'all got the same hat on too. To that one. I don't know if y'all did that on purpose.
And we talked about that. I told him. I'm right all my goodness.
But you know, since you know the tragic and unjust death of your nephew Oscar, I mean, you really have been on the front line. I mean, and nonstop. You know, since that time, going all over the country, being active around this issue, organizing families. And you know, you also had, you know, your story being told as well. Can you just talk about, also, to you, like, what about this movie really resonated with you? And then also, too, I, what made me think about you was when the brother kind of mentioned the stress of being out there. I think sometimes people see you on the front line, but don't understand what that really does to you emotionally. Can you just touch on that as well? I don't know what made me ask you that, but I'm just going to ask you.
the emotion in the documentary, really hearing these families' pain, right, and their expression, you know, I related to that. Because I can remember when I got the word that Oscar actually had died, I fell on my knees and I became extremely angry. It's, you know, I mean, thinking about it, every time I go back in time and I reopen their wounds, it's real painful. And so I have to try to gather myself so I can think and share where I'm at today versus what I was thinking about doing, as you talked about, Jerry, to put that beast back inside. You know, I say this, that helps me. I am so thankful that I reacted when I felt Oscar telling me to speak to him. About an hour, 20 minutes before he was murdered, he was really heavy on my heart. And we're talking about, it was about 12:40, New Year's Day. And I never ever texted him or called him at that time, but he was just really heavy on my spirit, and I responded. And I told him in that text that Uncle loves you, God loves you, God loves your family. And then he was murdered. But when I heard he was murdered, I fell on my knees, and that, of course, didn't come to mind. But when God brought it back into my spirit, how blessed I was to have had that opportunity. And also the community embracing us and helping me stand and begin to move forward in speaking about this issue. That became so critical in me being able to give that to others in hopes that they can also stand and become empowered so that they can help empower the community to generate this mass movement that we see happening all across this country. Because I didn't care where I went. You know, if one person heard me, that was important to me. Because I knew then that if we just keep doing this, right, and exposing and connecting the dots all across this country about it wasn't just Oscar. You know, that's not isolated. It was just, you know, Johannes Mensah made a mistake and that's rare, it don't happen. It was happening all across this country and I needed to connect those dots. So I decided that no matter how painful it would be, it was much more important for me to go through that pain to save a baby. That's where I'm at with that. And I heard somebody, I think it was you, I already said it in the documentary, this is about the babies. Yes. You see what I'm saying? We are at a state of emergency.
That's right.
And all of you that are in here, as Martin Luther King said, there comes a time when silence is for betrayal.
That's right.
You know, Frederick Douglass said it's easier to build strong children than it is to repair old broken men.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? So we have a responsibility. That's right. We have a responsibility to empower these youth, to empower them so that they can take the leadership of this movement so that we can make this place a better place for them babies that are coming behind them. That's what this is about. And so that's the type of pain that I go through, but I always think about them and how blessed I was to respond to Oscar that keeps me moving forward. Because it's not about me. It's not about us. It's about the generation that's coming behind us, and we all have a responsibility to respond to
it. So that gets me a blow right now. So we got some babies behind our hearts. And there's some babies, listen, there's some babies here that's working this thing, and they're here working this. And, you know, I believe the children are the future. Teach them well. Let them lead the way out there. He told me I couldn't sing, but I'm like, you know what? I'm Bill Withers up here, you know what I'm saying? to be started.
But no.